Hello, so today I'm going to show you how important it is to select the right antenna topology for a specific use case. For that, I'm going to use two different antenna prototypes that I made. One is adapted for free space only. The other one is adapted for devices that can be placed, for instance, on a metal plate, that could be a wall, that could be a table or whatever. So first of all, I will show you with an antenna simulation tool the radiation pattern of those two antennas and several parameters that cannot really be seen in reality, like radiation properties. So first of all, I will show you with a simulation tool, an antenna simulation tool, the radiation properties of the two different prototypes I showed you just before. Okay, so first let's start with the bad example. For this use case, which is basically a slot antenna printed on a PCB. So in this picture, you can see the slot antenna here in blue. Everything that is yellow is copper. And then you have also a little bit of FR4 material, which is PCB material. So now if we look at the radiation pattern of such an antenna in free space, you can see that it has omnidirectional radiation pattern, a relatively normal gain for this kind of antenna, which is about 2 dBi, similar to a dipole. And if you look at the total efficiency or radiation efficiency, it's close to 0 dB, which means no losses at all in this antenna. So it radiates all the energy that you can put inside the antenna. Now, if you put this antenna above a metal surface, what you will see is that the radiation pattern is completely modified. You have something that is then much more directive, about 8 dBi, and pointing towards the sky, so the opposite direction of the metal surface. Now, if you look at the total efficiency, you can see that it's down to minus 24 dB, which is really bad. And that's basically the reason why this antenna is not adapted for this kind of use case. So now if we take the second antenna type, which is in this case adapted to a use case of a device placed above a metal surface, you can see that the antenna is quite different, so it's not printed directly on the main PCB. It's printed on a secondary PCB. So here you have in yellow what we can call the main PCB, where you would have all the components. And in this secondary PCB, you can see the antenna trace, which would be printed again on FR4 material, this brown-gray material. What is important to see is that yes, the antenna is placed in a perpendicular way to the main PCB, but also that it's not at the edge of the PCB, but slightly in the middle. So now let's look at the radiation pattern of this antenna. We can see that it's still quite omnidirectional, though the axis of the radiation or the main polarization is slightly turned. And that's because of the position of the antenna, not at the edge of the PCB, and of course of the orientation of this antenna. Now, if we look at the efficiency of this antenna, we can see that it's about minus 3 dB, which is not perfect, but quite good. And we have a directivity still about 2 dBi. Now, if we place this antenna above a metal surface, we can see that the radiation pattern remains quite omnidirectional, though it has turn a little bit, so this is due to the presence of the metal plate. But what is very important is to see that the total efficiency has not changed that much. We are still at minus 4.5 instead of minus 3. But if we compare it to the first prototype that went down to minus 24 dB, this has nothing to do. Now I'm going to show you the impact of metal plate on both antennas frequency tuning and matching using this vectorial network analyzer that allows us to see the return loss of the connected antenna. So first, I'm going to show you the impact of this metal plate on the slot antenna, which is directly printed on the main PCB. So if we leave it in free space, we can see that the antenna is well tuned at sigfox frequency and well matched. Now, if we put the metal plate next to the antenna, we can see quite a big impact on the matching, but also on the tuning. So we can see that it's going down as soon as we move the plate closer to the antenna. If we place directly the metal plate against the antenna, we can see that the resonance has completely disappeared, which explains a big part of the efficiency reduction we saw in the previous part of this video. Okay, now let's look at what happens when we do the same thing with the other antenna, the one adapted to this metallic surface use case. Okay, so let's look at the return loss of this antenna, the one that is adapted to the metal plate use case, let's call it that way. So what we can see is that the bandwidth of this antenna is less wide or more narrow, but still it's well adapted at sigfox frequencies. So let's move the metal plate next to this antenna and see what happens. So when we approach it, we can see that almost nothing happened compared to the previous antenna. If we place the antenna directly against the metal plate, we still have a pretty good return loss. So basically, what we can see, if we take the frequency that is indicated by the marker number 3, is that it went from minus 9.5 dB return loss, which is quite good, to something even better, minus 15. So therefore, what is demonstrated with this is that it's possible to tune this antenna to work as well in free space as with a metal plate right below. Okay, the last part of this video is to show you actually the impact of having those two antennas in a real device. So I made two prototypes. So it's a simple sigfox module with a microcontroller to be able to send a sigfox frame plus batteries and of course the antenna. So you can see the two prototypes and we will see actually what happens on the back end. Okay, so let's start with the first one. So just to activate it, I have to switch it on. And okay, let's send the frame just by pressing this button. And if we look at the back end, let's refresh the page. Okay, so we can see that we just received a message. Now, if we do the same, in presence of a metal plate, so we send the second message. Yeah, just saw the message arriving, so it still works. But if we look at the amount of the base station and the RSSI level, we will see that it's completely different. So first of all, if we look at the amount of base station that received the message, we can see a big difference. So in the first case, we were received by about 12 base station, while in the second case, the one with the metal plate, we are only received by 5 base station. Then if we look at the RSSI level, which means the signal level received by each base station, we can see a difference of about 20 to 25 dB, depending on the base station. So if we take, for instance, the 6164, we see a level of minus 97 and minus 74 in free space. So that's more than 20 dB difference. Now let's look at what happened with the second antenna and basically the prototype, which is adapted to the use case where you place the device against a metal plate. So let's send a frame, a sigfox frame, and we'll see arriving on the back end in a few seconds. Meanwhile, let's send the second message, just arrived. So we placed the device on the same location, but just with the metal plate underneath. and let's send a second message. And then we will compare, of course, again, the results on the backend just received. So let's look at the results. Okay, so what we can see in that case is that both messages have been received by more or less the same amount of base station, which indicate that the antenna is working well on both situations, so in free space and when the device is placed against a metal plate. And then if we look at different base stations, so let's take for instance the 3CA5, we are received with a level of minus 88 with the metal plate next to the antenna, and minus 88, so same level without the metal plate, so in free space. We can do it with different base stations, so let's take for instance the 042C, minus 130 in free space, 042C, minus 132, which is only 2 dB difference. That can be explained by many things like propagation, but overall we can see the same level of sensitivity whether the antenna or the device is placed in a free space condition or above a metal plate. What we have seen in this video is two different antennas. So one that is not adapted to one use case, which is having a device above a metal plate, and one device which has an antenna adapted for this specific use case. What we have seen is that for the antenna that is not adapted, the impedance is impacted, the radiation pattern is modified. And if you look at the level of the signal received by the Sigfox network, it's really impacted. So basically you lose, in this case, 20 dB, but it could be even more. While with the right antenna, the impedance matching is not that much impacted. The radiation pattern is slightly modified, but still pretty good. And the impact on the received signal, almost nothing. I mean, we saw a difference of maybe 2 dB, which is nothing in the real life. So to conclude this video, again, this is crucial to select the right antenna topology for a specific use case. So if you need some advice for that, we can help you. So do not hesitate to contact us. Thank you very much.